I was talking the whole time, forgot my mic was muted. So, let me try this again. Welcome back, guys, to Farming Simulator 2022 on the Goldcrest Valley map. We are starting to get our new farm made here. So, we're going to start by cutting up this grass, and then we might go and cultivate this field and turn it into our little property here. So we're going to start this as a... Let's see how well this works. So it doesn't really matter. Nice. So a couple of things, guys. So I do want to give a shout out to a friend of mine. He's an old friend of mine from high school. He's the one who convinced me to start my YouTube channel back in 2020, and so I want to give him a shout out. His channel is Frogs with Opinions, so he kind of reviews like movies and stuff. It's actually a really cool thing to do, so go check him out. Detach. Let me just pull this tractor over here. We'll buy a larger one. Let's go ahead and just buy myself a nice large tractor. You know what? Let's use some of that. Let's go with a... I'm gonna go with a John Deere. Actually, let's go with a JCB. These are really nice tractors. Go with this one. Alright, let's switch. Let's just cut over here. So I own the three fields over here on this side. I would just hop the curb here. Nice big old JCB. I could have just gone with a medium tractor. Oh, yep, this is how you get grass done fast. Yep, we're just gonna... Okay, so it looks like that field right there. I own that field. For that one, I might actually call it something. I'm just cut all this grass down, sure. And we'll figure out, I'm thinking about maybe putting in a driveway that runs from the main road, all the way, and just bring like a nice little property. This, I think, is my goal for this video here. Yeah, we'll go ahead and create ourselves a property, but hope you guys are doing alright. I know content's kind of been, I really haven't made much recently. I've just been busy, but couple of things. So Battlefield RP will be coming to the channel very, very soon with 5M content making its return. I think I said that in the last stream, but that is what I'm thinking of, is bringing back 5M as soon as I can. So then, I know you guys really enjoy that. I'm thinking down the road, as a possibility, is doing a second channel split from this one that's just straight 5M, where this main channel, the second channel will be other games that I play, such as Farming Simulator 2022, American Truck Simulator, DMG, Roblox, etc. I don't know if I'll bring back Roblox series. But, yeah. I'm just as much fun. But my idea is to, so a couple ideas I have is to slowly start to bring Battlefield RP to the channel. There might be a video coming out, maybe in March, if something happens to a friend of mine. I'm going to make a commemoration video of some of his photos and kind of like talk about who he is if he ends up passing. But he is my best friend that I've known for 2 years. He's the one who owns Battlefield RP that I'm going to bring into life, hopefully this spring into the summer, so that we can start attracting guys into joining. But RP, yes, is going to be somewhat serious, but a few dongles I kind of just want to get out of the way here is that when you're role playing, okay, we're not going to be active staffing in game. What we'll probably end up doing is, if you mess up, we'll wait until the RP is over and then pull you aside and say, hey, we saw that you were doing this, can you not do it again? Like, just pull you aside, you're not going to be in trouble. It's just going to be, hey, we get that you're having fun. Just try to, you know, stay out of trouble. Like, you work with us, like, you work with us, we work with you. Like, that's the way, like, I would put it. Like, if you mess up, just be honest about it. But Battlefield RP is open 18+. I think whenever we launch and we see how things go for Lola, we may lower the join age, maybe down to 16. I would say would be good. Because it's hard trying to find people that are 18 enough to join a 5M server. Especially on one that's whitelisted. So, if I can get a 5M video out either COVID tonight. It is January 7th, 2024. I might see about getting a 5M video recorder put out, so then, or just do like server showcase video showing like some of the MMOs that we have in for that server. Starting to get you guys interested in what's to come. I know I said in a previous video about 5M's PLA. We're kind of just disregarding it because not many servers are making the change to use friendly lower police calls. Like, DOJ, one of the biggest servers, hasn't done it. OCRP hasn't done it. I guess it's probably just a warning to the manufacturers of those, but we're not going to worry about it unless something happens. Until we cross that bridge, we're going to stick with what we've been doing with 5M for years. So, I don't really like this fast track on this track. I'm gonna just back this up. So this one, kind of thinking, just look at this field. We could put a house right over there, like near that thing. So what I might do is do a driveway, like maybe on, or like, I think that's where we can store stuff. I might put a machine shed over there, but I definitely want to do like a dirt driveway, then do gravel. We're gonna keep this grass though, but we're gonna make it to where I can just use a lawnmower and not like this bigger one. And we're gonna take a look at the other two fields, and probably next episode be covering those two fields and seeing what we do there. And then we might create another series that's a branch off from this one on Piney Anchors. / Piney Run, just doing some logging episodes. So, I want to get your guys' opinion this year on what you want to see on the channel, because I'm looking to start pushing out more and more content. Now that I have all my computer kinks put away, I know I said I was going to upgrade my computer. I tried those upgrades. Didn't really work. My computer did not like the new RAM, so that RAM might get saved for if I build a secondary rig down the road, but we're just going to make do with what we have now. It's the best thing that we could do. So, it's really all that we can really do though. It's just work with what you got. But I know you guys have enjoyed, I know in last year you guys enjoyed the diverse roleplay videos. I know some of those were pretty funny. So, when Battlefield RP launches, I'm gonna be working with Misty Blaze. I think she has a YouTube channel. If you guys know her from my diverse days when she played on Blabber, like if you know Deputy Ryan Smith from those days, he has his channel. I don't think he posts anything, but I might actually post a short of me trying to shoot him. A couple years, like last year. See if I can just get the clip so that I can post it. Because when that clip was taken, I was a media member for Diverse. But I have gotten offers from the folks in Diverse to come back, but honestly, I've chose not to return because I get that they were QB core, like, it's not that I don't trust Chad. It's just that, that verse is just a whole different body. They're a little bit strict on the world, so I'd rather be money back than after the game. About, how do I put it? Like, having to worry about someone breathing down my neck in case I mess up. Because I'd rather work with the people than not be in a position where I can't do anything like I was in the metaverse. But another news is, Immersion Roleplay will be coming back to the channel with episode 28. I have no idea when I'm going to record that episode, but whenever they launch, I'm going to talk to them about me returning as a media member and getting when episodes recorded when I can for you guys. Until I can officially get Battlefield up and running, and I will be doing that more mainstream, because that's going to become my full-time server. So, just be on the lookout for Immersion Roleplay episodes 2, because those will be coming back. I said back in 2023 that they were going to reopen the server, but it kind of surprised me when they announced, hey, we were looking into the future, and Immersion Roleplay is making a comeback. It's like, nice. To see that, that's making a comeback. Because Immersion was actually a nice, small community. It was just members from DOJ that didn't really have that many roles. You just gotta roleplay, like, realistically, and don't do, like, in one of my videos I did a while back. Like, they said I met a game. I probably did just by accident without realizing it, and that's my fault, but we're not going to do that anymore. We're going to stick to a script, but roleplay is not about scripts. It's just about impromptu, getting in, having fun with your friends, and meeting new people. But that's enough on your own. I'm only actually talking more about Battlefield. I know I mentioned it a couple of times. So, Battlefield Roleplay is going to be a community where we offer actually something that other roleplay communities don't really offer. And that's going to be being able to play as like a young child. Like, have you ever dreamed like one day just being able to hop into a roleplay server and say, hey, I want to roleplay as like a 10-year-old child with someone like being the parents? That's what Battlefield Roleplay brings to the table. We bring in a whole new assortment of roleplay, from being able to play as kids to military RP, so we'll have in actual military vehicles for the civilian department, bringing in, hopefully, offering more than what no other server offers. But I've seen other servers like Greasy RP, DOJ, which I was a part of, but I said, like, whenever one of my videos, that I would try to bring DOJ content to the channel this year. I'm not going to end up doing so. I think I might end up retiring from DOJ just because it's not what I thought of. I have nothing against the people there. It's just not that fun. Because it's like, you kind of have to obey by their strict rules. And it's not really fun at all. When you have to get 1090 just because, let's say, you trigger a death script one too many times. Like, Like, that's what happened to me. Just one time, just, I was getting used to the server, so I didn't know all the rules. And then I got 1090 just for accidentally triggering the death script one too many times and F2. Apparently you can't F2 when you're in RP. But I'm gonna use that as an example because in Battlefield over, if you're gonna, like, say you're having issues with a ammo, you can F2 away from it until it loads and then you can drop it. And I will be doing a video either some point this week just showcasing our fleets and just showing what we have offer up to our deadline, which is June 25th is the grand opening. But I'm not gonna say if. Our grand opening is June 25th. I think it will stick with that date. But we might do a soft grand opening before the actual big one. So then we can start to get some of you guys in. Like, if you wanna join, that would be a good time because all you have to do is join is to go through a small interview phase with either myself, Brandon, or any of your gang. You have to join our Discord, interview, and we will get you interviewed. So the permits that we are offering, as I've already mentioned, we have our civilian team. We are looking for media members, people who love to create content for YouTube, Twitch, TikTok, Instagram. Even people who want to actually help edit videos, make TikTok shorts, YouTube shorts, like stuff like that that represent the community. And when you join, I am the media director, so when you get interviewed, it will either, I will be in there with Brandon, who is the owner of her now. Details will change in time. I don't want to give too many details about what's going on, but I'm sure you guys understand. Let's go ahead and fold this up. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and bring this tractor over and park it. So I'm thinking, we're actually gonna come down here. I'm thinking about putting in a driveway way right here that goes up and kind of wraps near that shed, or to where there's that little dirt road right there. So I'm gonna create like a dirt path. So I'm gonna park this JCB right here. We're gonna go ahead and shut this off, and now we can start the actual work of what we want. So let's, so this is what I'm kind of thinking. Landscaping, painting. So I kind of want to do, that's animal mine. I want like a dirt path. So then, So then it connects here, so then we'll make this a little bit bigger. I would just even it out just a little bit. And we'll do like right here. So this is our dirt. Let's say like our dirt little driveway here. And then in this corner here, I'm thinking about putting in a house. So let's go and grab a farmhouse. Or what we can do, how much is this ranch house? It's 100,000. I'm gonna rotate that because I want like the front of the house to be like right here. Oh, I like that. And then so, I kind of want to do, like, the house right here, and then maybe, so, house sits right here. I like the placement of the house. I think I'm going to do, let's see, how big is this? I think we'll do this one. Oh. Alright. What we're gonna do is that we're actually gonna rotate. And we'll do it like right here. Yeah, I kind of like that because then I can put all the machinery in there. So then what we'll do is we'll grab some gravel. We're just gonna turn all this into gravel right here. I would say that's good enough. And then I think maybe like down here I'll just do my own little silo. Let's go and do a silo. I kind of like these. And like this, I can just place on like. They're right there. Just need a silo. Then if I'm coming up, it's a little crooked, but we'll work with it. And on this side, I kind of want to put in like an animal pen. Actually, we'll do animals next time, actually. Let's do like decoration. Usually I do a fence, but or maybe say fences for next time too. water tower that I can put in. Oh, I could put in like, oh, maybe I could put in a pond. Have my own nice little pond, maybe. We'll think about that one. Is it under? There we go. I'm thinking about maybe like putting in this old water tower. I kind of just want to put this down here on the end of the property like that. And I'm probably put in this in, like, maybe, like, be, like, on the side of the shed, like this. This is what I'm kind of thinking. We'll buy a truck here shortly, but just want to check out the little property. So we got our Lizard Maverick here, X3. Alright, so we got our Stylus here.
Yeah, that's not bad at all.
I want to know if I can go inside of this, so let's see if it has material. So we're gonna park this right here. Ooh. This is nice. You play like chess, you got like a little crate. Oh, you got like a little, like a, maybe a Windows 95 computer here. So you got like a little gaming loft area. It's pretty cool. Okay, let's see what's in here. Washer, dryer. And I can change my clothes in here. Yeah, let's go ahead and change my clothes. Because it's kind of like fall, so let's go with like some lighter. And then, is there, that's like a nice little house. And then we could sleep. It's 11:45 in the morning. Alrighty. Let's just walk over here and check this out. Ooh. Oh, this is nice. We definitely, I'm gonna go ahead and probably buy some equipment just to have it. Got in that, workstation here? Let's go up here. This is like, I think this, oh, we got like some pallets, some wood. I think some piping here. We got ourselves a toolbox. A broom. This is actually really, really nice in here. Should much. Oh, and then we can come over here if we need to. Ooh, this is nice. Say we wanted some more light during the day to work on stuff in here. This is sick. We're gonna go ahead and close that up. We're gonna close up these bay doors. I'm gonna go. Actually, I'll leave those open actually here real quick. Because we're gonna come over here and grab this farm all tractor that I left down here. And we're gonna go ahead and bring that up to the shed. And then next time we'll probably put up a fence. We're gonna go buy a pickup truck here. So let's go ahead and just bring our equipment up to that shed. I kind of like that old water tower. We'll probably put in an animal pen there. I like this kind of elevated. It's not bad. And we will park this right here. We'll probably buy the other ones to go with this one. Then we have all three. I like these older tractors. We'll find a use for this one, but we'll leave it right here. And oh, that is actually sick. So if you look at, you can actually see the engines actually running. That is sick to see on these older tractors. Alright, let's go ahead and move this JCB up there. And we'll buy ourselves a pickup, check out these two fields, and see what they are all about. And then we're probably, you know what? I'll just make my life a little bit easier. So a park. I need to buy a pressure washer and clean that off after each use. But for the time being, we'll just back this up. And we'll just keep it in the back right here. Got ourselves a nice little property. Let's go ahead and shut that bay door. Like, this shed here is a keeper. It's nice, it's big. I could park my harvesters, different types of machinery in there. And that's what we'll do. And then we're gonna have this filled with gas for when I need it. Let's go ahead and go buy ourselves. Let's do a pickup truck and get those two other tractors. So I got a couple of add-on trucks in here. I should have a Ram that's a dually. No, I took that one out completely by accident. So what we will do then, we'll grab this. We will not be showing this on camera at all. I know I have the General Lee, but because of YouTube's terms and service, I will say this now. This will not be pulled out. You may see it in the garage from time to time, but I will not go up to it just because of the Confederacy flag on the roof. But we're going to go ahead and get our Silverado here. Make it look like my 2003 Silverado. But I'm going to give her an upgrade to what I wish my truck had. Ranch hand. Do this step options. Cab lights, yes. That option is cycle till hitch appears. CB options. We'll put in the CB. We're gonna do a gooseneck. We'll do a plow mount for the winter time. And I want to make this like a silver color. Like that. So then we'll buy that. And then I want to buy the other two Massey Ferguson the International, so I want to buy we'll make this one a twin mud guards both. I just want to have like some old tractors. I like these because they're old school. I just love the old school. Oh, you know what? I'll do this one the same way. Mud guards. Main color, let's make this one. Ooh. We'll actually leave it red. It looks better in red. And we'll make this one 51 horsepower. Alright, now we have those purchased. Let's go ahead and buy our trailer here. I kind of want to keep the wood. I like the wood. Gooseneck, extras. We'll do extensions, lubricant, grease, yes. Main color, we'll keep it. Actually, let's do silver to match the Silverado. Actually. Maybe, like, keep him. Alrighty. So now, ooh, what's that? Duramax. Let's go ahead and put the tailgate down so that I can poke down. though. Just so you can listen to that Darmax. That sounds really, really good. Alrighty, let's go ahead. If you kind of look with detail, you can actually see, like, the parts are actually moving in this tractor, which is really cool. It's a cool detail. These are big-ass tires. Holy shit. If I can scoot it over. Back it. Right there. I'm going to put down some tension belts. Keep her from rolling. That one's not going to go anywhere. Ooh. Oh, I like the steering. Those would have to be greased over time. I'd definitely say so myself. Alright, gonna get her loaded up. And then we'll come back for a harvester. We're gonna put a tension belt there. Right there, and right behind the wheel. And we are set. And I'll pull those up. And let's go ahead and... hear sirens in the game, but don't really have it. We will go ahead and get this onto the farm here. But guys, I think this is where we will wrap up this first episode of Farming Simulator 22. On the Goldcrest Valley map. I'm your host, Robert Maverick, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, guys.